Shubhodaya, good morning all. So we have been covering the different dimensions of yoga. So Bhagavad Gita is, as I mentioned previously, is an authoritative text in yoga. It is called Bhagavad Gita gives the psychotherapy. It's a psychotherapy. It says we are what our mind is. Manayeva manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayoho. If our mind is good, if our mind is elevated, however difficult situation we are in, we are not upset. For others, they might think that he is going through very hard time, but if the mind is elevated, we don't feel the difficulty. On the other token, if my mind is not elevated, it is low, however affluent I am, small problem, it upsets me a lot, that I can't control myself. That Bhagavad Gita tells us how to raise ourselves, how to elevate the mind. It's a Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita has 700 shlokas. Out of 700 shlokas, 574 shlokas were spoken by Lord Krishna. 84 shlokas were asked by Arjuna. 41 by Sanjaya and 1 by Dhritarashtra. All the shlokas are elevating, motivating for the seeker. One of the motivating shlokas that we all can remember, that from the Vishwarupa Darshana chapter, it's on the 11th chapter. I will tell the shloka first and I will repeat later. Tasma tumutishta.
Tasma tumutishta.
Yasho labhastva,
yasho labhastva,
jitva shatrun,
jitva shatrun,
bhungshva rajyam samriddham,
bhungshva rajyam samriddham,
mamai
vete,
nihata purvamevam,
nihata purvamevam,
nimitta
matram,
bhavasavya sachin,
bhavasavya sachin.
It's the meaning that bhavasavya sachin, savya sachi means one who is dexterous, very capable person, not to be despondent. That sometimes we think whether we can achieve or not, whether we can accomplish or not, or sometimes we think we did everything. We are too proud, or sometimes we are not sure, very depressed, whether we can do this job or not. I have so many things, can I commit on to this one also? It says, Savya Sachin, those who are able people, wanting to serve the people, wanting to accomplish things. For him, he is saying, O Savya Sachin, get up, conquer the world and enjoy, conquer your enemies. Enemies means your lower mind, and enjoy this world. And I have destroyed all the enemies already. You are just an instrument. Don't claim that you are doing. You are just an instrument. You take the glory, wake up and do. I have already done for you. That's very motivating. That many times we think whether we can do or not. It says, he is already, if we are ready, he has already done for us. And we are just an instrument. Take the credit. Or if you are taking the credit for everything, if you are saying, I am doing, he says, you are just an instrument. He has done for that. You are a pair of scissors in his hands. That scissors, it does not have its own kartrutva. It can't do its own. Somebody got to use the scissors. It's a 11th chapter. We will try to remember that one. It's a very motive. Nimitta matram bhavasavya sachin. And other texts are there. One step below is Patanjali Yoga Sutra. Patanjali Yoga Sutra, it assumes that seekers know, it doesn't talk much about asana part. It just touches on asana and pranayama, but it talks about how to raising the mind in different steps. Patanjali Yoga Sutra has 195 shlokas, sutras in four chapters. Four chapters, Samadhi Pada, Sadhana Pada, Vibhuti Pada and Kaivalya Pada. Four chapters are there. We'll explore that one in the following classes. And another text, Geranda Samhita and Hatha Yoga Pradipika. Hatha Yoga Pradipika is composed by Swami Swatma Rama in 16th century. It has 389 shlokas, and it talks exhaustively about asana, pranayama and kriya, shatkarma kriyas. Geranda Samhita and Hatha Yoga Pradipika go hand in hand. They go run together. Geranda Samhita has 329 shlokas, 229 sutras, and it divides the chapter into four areas. Seven areas. It talks exhaustively about asana, pranayama, and kriyas, mudras, bandhas, and seven chapters are purification. That first chapter is purification, how to purify ourselves through Shatkarma Kriyas. And second chapter, it talks about strengthening, how to strengthen the body. After purification, you got to strengthen the body, how to strengthen through asana. Third chapter, it talks about studying. After strengthening, you got to study. You should not be always moving here and there, how to study yourself through mudras. Fourth chapter, it talks about calming yourself through pratyahara, how to withdraw yourself through pratyahara. And fifth chapter talks about how to lighten yourself, feel the lightness in the body through pranayama. Sixth chapter, it talks about reflection, how to reflect through dhyana. And seventh chapter, it talks about isolation, how to isolate yourself, how to withdraw completely through samadhi. These seven chapters, Geranda Samhita talks about this one. And Geranda Samhita, Hatha Yoga Pradipika, and Patanjali Yoga Sutra. These are the stepping stone and ultimate culmination. It ends in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is the scriptures. Yoga seekers cannot afford to overlook that one. It is a handbook we got to carry personally in our heart always to motivate that Bhagavad Gita. It's a very inspiring book for all the yoga seekers. That we covered, it's four texts of yoga, and we'll talk about purification next week. Lie down on your back.